Hello students, I am Dr. Tanmay Vishwas and welcome you all in my channel Chemistry, the Mystery of Molecules. I hope you all are fine. So today we are going to discuss an important topic, that is endo or exo product in Diels-Alder reaction. This is the part of Diels-Alder reaction. I have already uploaded few lectures step wise about Diels-Alder reaction. So please visit if you want to learn them. But why this video I am making a separate? The main thing is that I want to strictly focus on this topic because in Diels-Alder reaction is a very important reaction, versatile reaction, and lots of topic need to be understood. That's why this specifically we will learn about this endo and exo product. Okay, so a lot of chemistry we will learn in this video. So I have one request that please watch the video until the end with complete attention. Remember, knowledge is not free, you have to pay attention. So let's start. Okay, by the way, before going to discussion, I have a small request. If you really like my teaching, then please do subscribe my channel, and most importantly, if possible, please support me through Patreon. Now let's come to our topic for today's discussion. Now, just look at Diels-Alder reaction. Okay, it is actually a pericyclic reaction. Means this di in here 4 pi electron and here 2 pi electron. Sorry, this is diene and this is dienophile. Dienophile, this is diene. They react. How do they react? This is a strategy. You can do the reverse arrow formation also. That's not wrong. This, this. And what they end up? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 atoms involved. So it's a 6-member ring. And one double bond here and these two pi bonds, these gone. Actually, this reaction is not sigma bond. This is the reaction of pi bond. So, this is the product of this 6-member reaction. Now, so, think in this case, what you can expect that two sigma bond. So, in this case, two pi bond consume and two sigma bond formed. Okay. So, from this point, we can say that delta S is negative. Why? From two molecules, you are getting one molecule, but delta H is positive. Okay. So, from this we can say that because of delta H, the reaction is spontaneous. Means the free energy change is negative. Okay. So, in this case, we can consider that this is the contributing factor at low temperature. But if you increase the temperature, then if you increase this T high, then this is contributing. So what happens? It come back. So remember, the first step is Diels-Alder, second step is retro Diels-Alder. And this concept will be important to get the endo-exo product. Okay, so since I told that endo-exo, what do I mean by the statement? Now, so endo means inside, exo means outside. And actually they are two, means in this case it's one. But if you take substituted, that's two. Just look at this example. There are two hydrogens, by the way. Fine. So this is, remember, furan is actually a cis di in a closed fashion, by the way. I have written this. This is actually butadiene. It could have cis trans, that isomerism, but only cis react, trans doesn't. Why? Because see, these plus these and these close, I agree, but these are this far apart. And remember, trans double bond in 6-member means if theoretically, just consider, if they react, what they will produce? This. But remember, this is a 6-member trans alkene. Not possible, minimum possible is 8-member, that is 12, but from 9-member onwards, that's fine. So this is not possible. So C is needed because proper because the product is not formation. And another thing, how the product forms? I'll come slowly. So this is actually a cis diene. It reacts very fast. And remember, among thiophene, furan, and pyrrole, furan is most reactive towards Diels-Alder reaction because it acts most efficiently as diene due to its less aromatic character. And I have discussed in a dedicated lecture. Please visit if you want to learn. So, just in this case, we will take furan because it's a very reactive. So, what happens if you react this furan and this is malimide? Means, see, this is malic anhydride. okay, and this is corresponding imide, you can consider, that's why it's called melimite. Now, and produces this and this both. By the way, generally, whenever you observe any Diels-Alder reaction, you observe that this malic anhydride is furan and malic anhydride. Then why I have selected melimide? Because malic anhydride, if you look at this oxygen versus this NH, so in which case these two carbon are most, means who is more electron withdrawing? This NH or this O? Obviously O, because first of all, nitrogen is less electronegative than oxygen. That is the most important. And second thing, there is a hydrogen, so polarity of this NH bond also with nitrogen means that NH bond will increase the electron density over nitrogen. That's why it will not prefer to withdraw from the carbonyl, rather than actually it donates to the carbonyl, because this nitrogen has a lone pair of electron. Okay, so that's why this pneumoconazole is a less reactive, and when it is less reactive, so some higher temperature needed. In reality, what happened? If you take this furan and melimide, they end up the exo product. I shall come after some time. Means first they produce endo, later the exo. Now, so in 25 degree centigrade reaction, means low temperature, what it produces? This produces this isomer, and this is called endo. And if you do the reaction little higher temperature, that is 90 degree centigrade, it produces this isomer, which is called exo. Now, a simple question. Why this is called endo and why this is called exo? Endo means inside, exo means outside. Okay? Means you have remember endocyclic double bond, exocyclic double bond. From that you can come here. Fine. So why endo? See, this part, just I am, my pen, for focus on my pen, this part. Okay? This part is closer to this double bond. That's why this is called endo. And by the way, remember there are two hydrogen, means this hydrogen and this hydrogen. Now, this is closer, and in this case, this is far apart. See, these hydrogens are closer to this. Now, if I ask you a simple question, which is most stable between endo and exo? Obviously, you should say that, sir, exo is most stable. Why? Because, see, this bulky group closer to this two protons and this pi bond. And pi bond just not a double bond. It means the homo, this is an electron cloud. Okay. This is above and below electron cloud. So that can interact. So electron-electron repulsion. This is my personal opinion. But steric is another opinion. Both. Now question is. So why this is stable? Because it's outside. Okay. And see, you may say that, sir, there is one oxygen. So these they are far apart. Just look at this bond is that side. Okay. So no. So means this is more stable. And this is relatively less stable. That's why this is called KCP or kinetic control product. And it is called TCP. Okay. Now, a simple thing that if you do a reaction from here, you are coming to this, means this is actually a KCP. Let's consider. So TCP is more stable. Obviously, this TCP, and this is the energy, and this is the RC, means reaction coordinate. Fine. No. So the energy of activation for the KCP, delta E better to say, and this is delta E TCP. So remember that delta E TCP is always greater than delta E KCP. Okay. Now, so first of all, KCP produces very faster rates, true, but the reverse reactions energy of activation. Means you can consider retro Diels order. This delta E R KCP. And this is delta E R TCP. Now in which case? In this case, delta E R TCP is also greater than delta E R KCP. So, if it is less, then this KCP could be converted to intermediate and can come here. But since this energy of activation is very high, means delta ETCP, it cannot come back to this reactant. Got it? This is the important concept. Now, how to utilize this concept? See, this is a very high barrier, not possible. So if you do the reaction under relatively higher temperature, as I told, retrodyl solder dominate that time. So what happens, this KCP what produces, it can undergo retrodyl solder. You can logically say that, sir, theoretically ETCP can also undergo. Obviously, but am I giving that much temperature which is needed for TCP to come in the retro state? No, I am giving an intermediate value of temperature where this KCP to this possible. And now what happens, this KCP versus reactant is in equilibrium. Means this versus this in equilibrium, but from the equilibrium something is converted to TCP. And it cannot come back. So after certain time, under this higher temperature condition, these KCP will be converted into this TCP. And that is exactly happened. If you take this KCP and heat it 90 degrees centigrade, it will result the TCP. Now let's come to our previous point. Why I have selected this amide? See, because it's a 25 degrees centigrade. So means room temperature, you can isolate the KCP. Then you can further heat it 90 degrees centigrade, you can heat. So in this way, the whole hypothesis is correct. Now, question, why not furan and maricon hydride? See, as I told that maricon hydride is an extremely electron deficient molecule. So what happens? In this case, it reacts very fast. And ultimately, product is the TCP. Means, if I draw... Student, I request you, please draw with me, because if you don't practice the drawing, you will not learn properly. Sorry, not NH, this is O, and this is this. Now, so this is, but question is, does it produce this endoisomer? Obviously, but it's so reactive, means furan ultimately end up with this. And why reaction stops here? Because this is more stable. Okay, TCP is always more stable. Now, we have understood this thing very fine. That what happens, how happens. Now question means what happens. Now question, how this happens. And since we are discussing Diels-Alder reaction, then it is needed that we should learn about the molecular orbital point of view expansion. Okay. So, how the molecular orbital reacts. So, in this case, you have to understand one point. Means, this is a diene. We are not going to change the diene. So, in case of dienophile, what is expected? Means, in case of diene, what do we expect? That if it attaches to electron withdrawing group, for example, aldehyde. Reaction is favored. We consider that the diene must be electron rich and dienophile must be electron deficient. And that is the best condition for Diels-Alder reaction. And in this case, what is the expected product? In this case, the expected product is this. Now question appears. Will it be towards inside or outside? Because when you are discussing simple double bond means the L-ethylene, it doesn't matter which one is outside because it is substituted. This is substituted. Okay. So, first of all, you understood electron deficient, diene must be electron rich and this is electron deficient. Why? Because they are molecular orbital interaction. And I think you must know the molecular orbital. Right now, I will give very short way. Okay. So, let's draw. And remember, since I am discussing about cis diene, so our drawing must be in cis fashion. Okay. So how this cis diene, this is, and this is the alkene. Now, diene has four atomic orbitals are involved in this case. So four molecular orbitals will produce. Means psi 1, psi 2, psi 3, psi 4. And in this case, if you check, means I am giving a very brief idea, just think that two atomic orbitals reacted and produces two molecular orbitals. See, two pi bond reacts and produces, when two p orbital reacts, in this case produces, this is a pi and this is pi star is vacant. Similarly, this is the pi and this is the pi star. Sorry, pi star should be vacant. Pi star vacant. Now, pi star is vacant. Now, just think. Just forget these atomic orbitals. This is pi and this is pi star. So, this pi and pi star can combine together. Okay. So, if they combine, what will they produce? This. So, first, this pi these two combine, this two pi. This is further overlap. This is field, because these two involved are field. Now just look at this molecule. So this is called psi 1, this is called psi 2, this is called psi 3, this is called psi 4. Got it? These are the molecular orbitals. Now, in this case, who is homo for dying? So, this psi 2 is homo. Highest occupied molecular orbital. And this psi 3 is lumo. Lowest unoccupied molecular orbital. Okay, fine. So, now, this homo and lumo. Now, in this case, a simple question. Who will act as a die-in? Who will act as an electron donor in this case? Since it's homo, it will act as electron donor, because it is act as a donor and this is acting as an acceptor. Okay. Why I am saying this statement? See, just sometime before I told that if it's electron rich, reaction is fluid. Electron rich means it can donate, and electron deficient means it can accept. Simple thing. Oh, fine. So this is actually acceptor. So acceptor means which orbital it can accept. This has only two orbital, one pi star. So it will accept electron pi star. If I draw the pi star, how it looks? So pi star is, this is one. In this way I am drawing because it's easy to visible. No pi star, because pi star has a sigma plane in this case. Okay, now, so another thing. Now if I draw this homo, okay, what it should look like? See, just look at, remember, this psi 1 means there is no nodal plane. Psi 2 means only one nodal plane. Okay. So in this case, only one nodal plane. Just first draw four orbitals. Now use your common sense. How one nodal plane could be given? If you give one nodal plane, rest of things symmetrical, not possible. So another option here. If you give one nodal plane means, if you give, sorry, this. So only one nodal plane symmetry, but rest thing should be same. This. Okay. So now, just you have got this. That what previously I told, remember, try to remember. This will react with this, and this will react with this. So from that concept, you can say this orbital will react with this. This orbital will react with this. And how this reaction happened? Because symmetry matches here. See, this is, remember, in order to happen a reaction, two things important. First of all, energy matching. Second thing, symmetry matching. So this is the symmetry matching. Okay. And another thing, donor means higher energy. This is acting as a homo, so fine. And acceptor, withdrawing group, energy level of the pi star will down. That's why, so that's why their energies matches. Fine. Question, this much part we have understood, how this disorder reaction is happening. Now next the thing, that how the electron withdrawing group contributes. Okay, so that is the question. Now, as I told, reaction happens easily because this is the criteria, that homo must be electron rich and lumo must be electron deficient. So question, why this reaction happens easily? It means some type of interaction possible. And remember, a reaction happens faster. What is the simple meaning of this statement? The corresponding energy of activation is lower. Or, when you add some catalyst to the reaction becomes faster, because catalyst reduces the energy of activation. Okay? By forming some adapt with reactant, such that reaction can happen under low energy condition. Similar exact thing happens. Now, Just look at this. What we have added? This is actually an aldehyde. Let me draw the thing again. So, student, be very much careful when you indicate the phase of the orbital, because if you make mistake, it will be difficult for you to find out the right answer. Fine. Now, when we are saying that it attached to an acceptor means this aldehyde. So what it can do? It can be endo, means inside, closer to the double bond, this, or it can be exo. Let's discuss the endo thing. So draw endo means inside, means closer to the double bond. Endo means inside, means these are closer. Means if the aldehyde group need to be closer to the double bond, means inside, then it goes to the back side. No. I know it's very little difficult, but please try to understand. So, double bond attached. Now this is the carbon and this is the oxygen. In this case, it is also a pi bond. So what can happen? This can also have these orbitals. I think I should draw it a little better way. First, this two. So this is oxygen, this is carbon, means the orbital involved here. Okay? And what we told our previous, these two, this diene, CC double bond, this is C, this is C. So this is this. Actually, student, based on my drawing, do not conclude anything about the orbital size. I can't draw properly, but fine. Now, but there is size change. We will come in some other video, because lobe size also changes. Just in this case, to make the situation simplify, I'm showing this. So, first, this is two interaction. And this interaction is called as primary interaction. Primary interaction. Why primary? Because this is the most important criteria for this bond, because these two need to react, otherwise how reaction will happen. So this as a primary interaction. And what is the secondary? See, this diene actually is an electron rich molecule. So what can happen? This can have some, the what I have drawn, the pi star of C double bond O. This is the C, this is the O, this is the pi star. Got it? So this, now just look at, based on the symmetry, you can conclude. Don't be confused that, sir, these and these are not interacting, these orbital lobe, this. No. Because if you look at this molecule is like this. Alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl. So how these and this can react? Not possible. Okay. So by the way, I have already discussed a dedicated lecture on alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl. Please visit if you want to learn more. This cannot. Based on my drawing, I want to show it. Actually, the thing is, interaction is in three-dimensional. I am trying to present it in two-dimensional. That's why the confusion may arise. But please don't get misunderstood. No, fine. So, this also interaction possible, this interaction, and this is called secondary interaction. Now, who is highly contributing? Obviously, primary is more contributing. Fine, that's why reaction happens. But the secondary has significant effect, that's why this endo-exo variant. Now, okay, so if that's why secondary interaction. And as I told, what is KCP?
KCP means kinetically controlled product. Kinetically controlled product means the corresponding energy of activation is higher. How the energy of activation lower, and how the energy of activation could be lower? By some stabilizing interaction, like catalyst binds with some substrate and gives stabilization to the substrate, and they can come closer react. Exactly. Because of this interaction also, it prefers to remain closer to each other and reaction happens smoothly. That's why you can locate that 25 degree centigrade endo product is dominant. Okay, so from this simple example, I guess you have understood why this endo product produces efficiently. In case of this, at low temperature, it is endo, and high temperature, if you go, that is exo. Fine. So, this why I have shown this, because this is the easiest example. Now let me go to little difficult example. What do I mean? Just let's watch this example. Or you can think that furan or melimide like that. Furan or this malic anhydride, I'd say. This is malic amide, malic. So in this case, let's draw the molecule. So endo means inside. This part inside. So double bond is outside. So the rest of the things are inside. This, got it? Now look, let's draw the orbitals. This is the alkene. This, so let's draw it here. And by the way, student, I should draw a little carefully, more logically, better to say. If I draw it more logically, this must be down, such that you will not get confused. And this is front side, means towards me, towards you. Okay, now. So, the orbital, this is the di, fine. And see, it has a bonding interaction, this, fine. And this is the primary interaction. Now, in this case, how the secondary interaction operating? See, the orbital. Now, in this case, who is just previous case, it is different. See, now this is also a kind of pi star, this is also a pi star. And in this case, this carbon orbital means this and this. This is the secondary interaction. Now you can ask me a question that, sir, previously C double bond O overall you have discussed. In this case, why C not the oxygen you are considering? See, in order to have an interaction, they need to come close enough. Just try to remember the trans one. Trans-dimethyl solder. Theoretical question. Because these and these cannot come close to here. Such that how this interaction will happen? If you physically think, in this case, there is the orbital. Is it able to come closer? So, if it cannot come closer, then how the overlap will occur? And if the overlap cannot occur, then how the bond formation possible? Okay, so that's why this oxygen right now will not participate. So, this. Now, ultimately, if I give you little brief about this, means how the product should look like. Now, after reaction, just this is the parent one, form a new bond, this, fine. Now with this it forms a bond, okay, and this is one new double bond is produced. Now what about the other part? The other part is this means this is backside NH, this, and this is the double bond. Fine? Means the double bond than NH is closer. Okay? Now if you draw it in a little different way, it will look like this. Okay? So, So this is the overall discussion for this Diels-Alder reaction. So now I guess you have understood why this produces N2 and why this produces X2. Second thing, why furan, if you react with malic anhydride, ultimately ends up the XO1? Because it is true that it reacts with faster to produce the KCP, that is the endo. But it is so reactive that it instantly converted into the XO. Because the withdrawing effect of oxygen makes it super, better to say super diinophile. Okay, and that's why this reaction used as a quantitative tool, means this furan malic anhydride, it's a quantitative reaction. Okay, so now in today's discussion, what we have learned? We have learned the endo XO, why they are produced. But another thing, just we have discussed the acceptor part. Fine, we got it. Now, if we consider the dimerization of, if we consider the dimerization of cyclopentadiene, see, this one molecule of we know the cyclopentadiene remains in the form of dimer, so you can consider that this 2 cyclopentadiene. Okay, by the way, you may be confused that sir, this cyclopentadiene has polio, it became smaller. No, obviously no. Fine. See, which one is reacting primary interaction? This and this. So this is actually primary. Secondary interaction, this and normal trans. So in this way, you can also consider that cyclopentadiene also can give endo and exo by doing the similar way. Because generally, the questions are taught in this way, that's why fine. But the other one is also true, just in case of carbon-carbon double bond, that also similar. Because we need a pi bond, that could be carbon-carbon, carbon-oxygen, like that. Fine. No. So we have understood this and the contribution of retro-Diels-Alder. And that is heat-mediated, entropy-dominated or entropy-controlled. Fine. So this is the overall discussion today. I believe this video may be useful because we have learned a lot of mechanistic process. Please write your opinion in the comment box and please, if possible, please help my channel to grow. And please like this video because it motivates a lot. Okay, so thank you again. Stay happy, stay blessed. See you in my next video. Bye-bye.